Hey everyone, I'm Kyle.
And I'm Clayton.
And we're your original GMs from Warriors of Light. Today we want to continue our discussion about character creation.
We're going to be talking about the don'ts of character creation. Things you want to avoid when you're developing a character or when you're conceptualizing one. Things you want to avoid that's going to, in the long run, help you out and keep your character much more interesting for others to see.
Exactly. Because there are a lot of ways to do the wrong thing when it comes to making your character.
Unfortunately.
And we want to help you avoid slipping into those pitfalls.
Because we got your back.
One of the don'ts is to not always be an orphan. I've seen more times than not, players want their characters to not have any family, not have any, as we'd mentioned before, emotional ties to make them real and tied into the world in some way. And being an orphan is definitely one of the avenues that is often taken. But that comes with a few disadvantages, as you have less things for your character to care about. You have less ways that the game master could probably tug at the heartstrings of your character. And we're not saying that the orphan route is always bad.
No.
Just make sure to do it with moderation.
Let's say your character is an orphan. What does your character care about at that point? Are they a hero just for personal gain? Without family ties, then it's just all about money or new gear or leveling up. That limits you very much from having an actual impactive roleplay experience. Your character at that point becomes very shallow. A lot of people don't want to RP with somebody who's just a money hungry, level up, you know, hog. They're more interested in somebody with rich, flavorful interactions, rich, flavorful history, and people and loved ones that your character would care about.
The big problem with being an orphan is when you decide, I just want my character to be an orphan because I don't want to have to worry about their backstory. That's your big mistake right there, because the backstory is, as we had mentioned before, one of the largest contributing factors to having an enjoyable character for the future. It can get a little weird when every single one of your characters are orphans. It's kind of strange. A nation unto themselves.
Yeah.
Also, avoid the amnesiac. Now, your character is a prominent character in the world, or at least that's what you're trying to make the character to be. They're supposed to be somebody interesting. And somebody that has no personality is not very interesting. And one of the ways that can come out that they don't have any personality is if they don't ever have an opinion. Your character needs to have opinions about things because they are an individual and their view on the world and situations around them needs to matter.
A lot of times people that don't have an opinion have a difficulty developing their character too. Sometimes it's a better chance to leap on something that you could possibly have an opinion on than stay quiet. You don't always know who your character is simply the first time you create them. Sometimes you gotta walk in their shoes. Sometimes you gotta talk and be them with interacting with other people and situations to actually be introduced to them and find out who they really are.
If something comes up where your character has a position that they feel very strongly about, maybe in the adverse to whatever is going on, and you don't let them express that, that's a lost opportunity for them to show a part of their personality or what they believe.
Another thing that can kind of hinder you in your character is actually having too much passion for one thing. Emotional and mental tunnel vision. You only have one goal, one thing you're after. Which that can be interesting and it drives your character in the beginning, but later on, your character can't really become somebody else. It's always good to be able to pick up other things you care about, such as a small child that's injured. Instead of the paladin so concerned with, I must always be for my deity, maybe he has time to stop and help this child that is poor or lost his family. That's a care. That's something that will derail your character and give it much more personality. So that way you're not stuck in the rut of only single-minded goals.
And characters are supposed to be, to a level, complex. Not that you can't have your character be extremely focused on their goal. A lot of the great characters that I've witnessed in the past have been very focused on whatever it is they're trying to achieve. But they were also able to look left and right and see what's going on around them and have thoughts and opinions and beliefs about those things as well. Another thing to avoid is to design your character with the thought in mind that they know everything or can do anything. That makes them rather uninteresting because, oh, this character doesn't need companions, or this character doesn't ever need help. This character has already reached their pinnacle, which nobody really cares for characters that have already, at their first level, they've already reached the pinnacle of what they can achieve. Part of a successful character is to have them progress, to get better at things, to have their skills be sharpened and their knowledge grow. It's good for your character to have weak points. Now we kind of want to move into talking about attachments between a player and their character that can be rather unhealthy. So we want to talk about piggybacking. That's the idea that your character is piggybacking off of another character.
If you're going to RP as though, say, your husband and wife or something inside of your RP game, it can be very risky unless you've RP'd with that person before and you know how to react with them. Otherwise, you can end up attaching yourself to somebody that has different goals, different views, and maybe different convictions than your character does. And in so doing, sometimes you'll just follow the leader.
If you mimic someone else's character, not to say that you can't pull inspiration from their character and do other things with it, but if you're a mirror copy of them, well, that just is a detriment to your character and theirs.
Yeah. Somebody that's being copied, at first they'll seem flattered or interested as though they'll take your character under their wing. Later they find out they're kind of stealing my thunder. Eventually, this scenario here always ends up petering out to something unwanted, and you're left with a character that you really don't care about. More times than not, in our RP experience, we see these characters asking the GM, hey, I'd like to make a new character, or I'd like to develop them different via the storyline, because they've become uninteresting. Another pretty big don't is being afraid to let your character die. Character death can be the most epic and most interesting part of your character. If you're not willing to let them pass away, then you're once again going towards that invincible mindset. If you don't have fear of death or the possibility of death, you also can't experience that fear, which I said before, keeps things flavorful.
If your character dies, that's actually one of the greatest opportunities for them to be remembered. And to deny them that moment of death, well, that's stealing a lot of the potential of what that character could achieve as far as an emotional high and memory. If you're playing a game where HP is a factor and you're not willing to let your character die, you might want to find a different hobby.
Another don't is not being willing to let your character's goals change. So you have to allow your character to redirect themselves in a sense. A good GM should always be providing different hooks and different interests during the pathline for your character to latch onto. But if you just stay fixated on that original goal, you may never meet it. So be flexible.
You need to allow your character's goals to change so that way you, as a player, can enjoy where the story is going. Another really big don't is to be unwilling to let your character fail. Your character's failures can define their success later on, and it makes the success be all the more sweeter once your character finally obtains it.
Low points in your character's story, or things that they weren't able to achieve, these situations create scars on your character. Failed to save the girl, she ended up dying. Maybe that emotionally changed your character. Scars in any kind of RPG on your character are actually good things because they give your character reason. Or say, once again, that woman dies that you were trying to save in the game. Later, there's another opportunity to save one of your comrades. I will never let that happen again. That's an emotional hook that your character now has.
If you were to be in an environment where you could never fail, you never lost, the world would become terribly mundane and boring. So it's the successes and the failures being at a proper balance allow for a great story to be told.
You're the one telling the story of your own character. And if you're not utilizing these bad situations, then you're only doing it to the detriment of yourself. Because that's one of the best tools any game master or any game moderator can give a player. The opportunity to fail.
Just don't get upset when your character does fail. Let your character be enriched by it. Let it scar or shape or enhance your character in some way.
Exactly.
All right, well, that's all the time we have for this video. Thanks for watching it. It's been our don'ts of character creation. So make sure to like, share, and subscribe this video and check out some of our other videos. And until next time, be the adventure. Dang it, I had a really good point.
It's my beard straight.